follow a cow? The priestess from the Oracle said to follow a cow? A peculiar command, to be sure, but then the priestess is never wrong. She promised that great things would come to the person who follows her cow until it lays down to sleep, and then builds a city on the spot. This person will be able to achieve something that four powerful men failed to achieve, and finally bring Europa back to Greece. The beautiful Europa was abducted years ago by a white bull, and has not been seen since. And thus, the priestess's bovine-centric prophecy came to an end. The cow did not choose a very good spot. She fell asleep a short distance from a hideous multi-headed serpent that purportedly belongs to Ares. The monster is always ravenously hungry and eats everything that comes near him. Building a city here won't be easy, but the promised reward is irresistible.
Brand new series, Zeus, Master of Olympus. So I'm doing the first quest card. What was it again? I forgot. Zeus and Poseidon, maybe? Or was it Europa? Something like that. I'm doing the voiceover after doing the recording portion. So now I'm doing the houses for the civilians to show up. I'm leaving a space to place the agora, that way they'll have vendors to be able to get food and clothing from. Common agora right there. So I'm going to place the roadblocks, that way whenever my workers start going around, they will not go past that point. The maintenance office is to make sure there's no fires or buildings collapse. As you can see, the roadblocks are working there. Now I'm going to do the fountain, which employs the water bearers, and they go around making sure all the houses have water. So I think I'm looking for the bridge. So I can go over there and do some agricultural type of things. Placing a roadblock there to make sure my workers over on that side do not go by. Or go past it, and it'll be just better that way. So I'm putting the wheat farms down. It'll take a while before the harvest is able to be whatever that's called. And the granary is to keep all the food available there. So I'm going back and seeing what my people need. There's the food vendor there. I need more workers, so I should have probably put more houses down. So I'm making this new road so I can add more houses, I believe, right through there. Yeah, there we go. I leave a space in between because the neighborhood appeal needs to be pretty high, so I'm doing that to put in benches and what's it called, pillars and stuff. So now we have two neighborhoods. I'm going to put the unsavory type of buildings, right? Way over here, that way the houses won't be affected by the low appeal of the buildings. So a collapsed building, that's the granary. What happened was I forgot to put the maintenance building over there. So that's what I'm doing right now to make sure that my buildings here do not collapse again. Placing a new granary down. Luckily the food hadn't been finished being grown yet, so that's one good thing. So at the moment I'm going to be going through and let's see what I do. It's kind of hard to do voiceover while watching the video at the same time because you don't remember what you did. So I'm just sitting here waiting to see what happens. Okay, so it looks like I'm going through to see if, okay, we need a bridge over here, so that's what I believe I'm doing right now. And connecting it with the road. Because on this side, you see the purple things there. That means you can put granaries, orchids, or orchards, or whatever it's called, like trees and stuff. Orchid is the flower, right? So orchards, I believe is what I was trying to think of. You can put goats and sheep and any kind of agricultural thing there. Which is what I'm doing here. Okay, you can see doing a lot of olive trees there. Making sure I got the maintenance thing right there. So at that point, I'm just checking to see what the houses need in order to evolve. And here I'm putting the new agora. You see there's food right there. I'm putting a granary there because the other one is too far, so I'm putting that one there to make sure the agora food vendor things have access to food. You probably noticed the road beside the granary place like get lowered as far as how it looks. That means the appeal is not very good. So now I'm putting down sheep, and sheep will allow you to get the wool you need for clothing and stuff. And I believe I put down the dairy shack also for the cheese. There we go, so I put that down. I noticed watching the video that I need to get something like the palace put down so I can get the taxi started. I think that's one of the things I do next pretty soon. So the olive oil that eats the storehouse there. So I'm putting that down at the moment, that way I can get the gift of the olive oil. Again with the maintenance thing to make sure the building does not collapse. And I'm placing the roadblock there to make sure the guy there doesn't go past that point. I don't have fleece yet, but that's one of the things you need to do is make fleece and send it off. But the main objective is to get 1,000 citizens in your city, which you can see nowhere near us, but we need up in the middle of the top there. It says 152 citizens. So I put in the storehouse there, so both of the, I think I do a granary also, to make sure there's a halfway point where everything is situated. That's for the olive oil and the fleece in the upper corner of the screen. So as you can see here, I'm making a new neighborhood there because I need more workers and everything, so that'll help a lot. I think this one I was trying to make a more higher tiered neighborhood, but I don't have those particular agoras yet. Because those ones I need are on both sides of the road. Just placing that down to make sure the guy doesn't go past there. You can see there's wolves right there. If the herd is close enough to there, they'll attack them and kill them. And here I'm doing the maintenance place and also the water fountain. At that point, I'm trying to figure out how to get food over into that one granary. That's why I'm going back and forth like that.
I'm not moving until you hire someone to help me unload these goods.
So I don't think there's a way to get rid of the wolves, unless the hunter's cabin or lodge or whatever it's called. I don't know if they do the hunting for wolves or not, or something else they do.
I'm not
However,
moving until
that's
you
probably
hire
something
someone
to
to
look
help me
into.
unload these goods.
And the wheat is at a standstill because there's not enough people to work in the granaries.
This city is more refreshing than any other city, and its leader is the most sparkling.
Have you ever seen more solid buildings? Archimedes would be proud.
So now that there's food at the granary, they are transporting it over to the agoras. And then once that happens, the houses are going to evolve. That way you can get more civilians in the houses. So that's what the food vendor is doing now. You can see how the houses are evolving now. So for the first culture venue, it's always a good thing to have a gym, because having just one of those is enough to evolve the house again. The other one, other buildings, they need two different things to have people culture-wise go through. So I like to put these columns in between the houses to make it look more appealing for the city. And then parks behind them are always a good thing. In the corners, you may also want to do like benches and stuff. And that'll increase the appeal of the neighborhood, as you can see right there. So the tax collector is another building you want away from your main houses. Those things also decrease the appeal of the neighborhood. But you do want the palace near them, because that one increases the appeal. So here we have the college and also the podium for the philosophers. That's another cultural aspect for the city. So you want to put the auto press near the trees as in order to get the olive oil really fast. So there's a plague in this neighborhood because there's no food in Agora. So they're not healthy or anything. Looks like it's about time to create a new storehouse. And here I'm putting down the olive oil vendors, that way the houses can evolve again. And the storehouse over here, that way if needed, it can be used for the neighborhood nearby. Thank you. forgot to mention the healer's hut, or healer's hospital thing, is there for the plague victims.
Under your leadership, Thebes is beginning to thrive. Yet the multi-headed menace still plagues the land, and the city will never be truly great as long as it counts the monster as one of its residents.